Hi all, and welcome back to our Skyrim. Sorry, I've just been playing a little bit of Skyrim. Yeah, sorry. Minecraft Let's Play Old World Revived. Yeah, today, well, we're gonna start off with the proverbial cup of Joe, and as you can see here, my guy has a bucket of milk in his hand because, yeah, well, why the hell not? So, I'm gonna challenge you guys. No, I'm not challenging you, but I want to do this with you guys. Go out, pause the game when I say so. Pause the game, then go out, get a cup of milk, a cup of Joe, like me, a cup of coffee, or whatever you want, any kind of beverage you want. Come back, and we'll do a celebratory or a group, like cheers, if you want. Okay? Pause the game now. Okay. Have you gotten your beverages? I hope you have, because, yeah. For me here in the real world, and for my character, which I cannot... Why can't I drink a bucket of milk? Why can't I drink a bucket of milk? What the fuck? Does my character have to be so goddamn... There we go. Do I really have to go and get a bucket of water? Why can't I drink it? God damn it. Oh well, screw it. Then my character can't do it. Then we're gonna do it in real life. I thank you all for tuning in today. And yeah. As always, I'm not gonna say catch on the flip side because we're just starting. Nope, not at all. Screw it. Let's go back. Thank you all very much for tuning in. And cheers. Bottoms up. Oh, that's a good cup of Joe. Please write in the comments below if you did it and what you drank, because I would like to do this more often, be more interactive with you guys. And yeah, today we are going to continue on our, our little, operation down here with the magics and stuff like that. Let me see here, we are... Okay, where the heck is my book? Where the bloody hell is my book? Oh, I think... Ah, yeah. Sorry, I've completely forgot that I made a little tip down here where I put it in. Yeah. Okay, because I was afraid that the lava underneath there would actually burn the chest, but I don't think it does. So, our quest today, well, one of them, hoping we can do more. Yeah, I know. I'll put the ink there, okay. Is to find out what symbol this is. So, without further ado, let's go out. Oh, no. I've cleaned up the chests, as you can see. Thorncraft chest, Ars Magica chest. Let us, yeah. For some unknown reason, I don't know, mobs and monsters have stopped spawning, SHUT UP, PHONE! God damn with your cow noises. Turn off the sound, there we go. Oh my god. Yeah, monsters have stopped spawning in the old area here. So yeah, it's a bit weird, but let me just think for a moment, didn't I? I thought I brought back a... spawner from Twilight Forest. I think it's over here. There he is. You remember these small idiots, these small guys down here. Yeah, well, I've got multiple of those spawners that we're gonna bring back from the Twilight Highlands. Oi. Damn, I got the hiccups. So, let's, go back to the Twilight Forest. Yep. Going into bat form so we can fly. Fly like an eagle. Well, that'd be cool. Hey, how you doing down there, Rudolph? Oh my God. Yeah, sorry, I just thought of something. I had another name tag, right? What if we took one of those name tags? I got three of those reindeers in my pen at home. Why not name one of them Rudolph? That could be cool. Oh yeah, so now you're gonna see how far down my quarry has actually come. And why I've said in my other that it is picked up speed like a son of a bitch, because it has. As you can see, here are the spawners. I've picked them up and placed them up here because the quarry here would actually have destroyed them completely. It would just destroy them. It picks up chests and anything that's in the chest, but spawners and stuff like that, it will destroy. Whoop, shit. As you can see here, damn. It is reducing this mound of epic proportions or epic goodness and loots and stuff to, yeah, nothing. Just a goddamn hole in the ground. Yeah, that's a thing. That's apparently a thing. Oh my God. So yeah, let's go up and get the spawners. But I've realized that it is a bit tricky to get the spawners through the portal. What have we got here? We got a cave.
Oh, yes, it's a trap. Just do it.
Yeah, we got a cave spider. We got a Twilight Forest recap. I have no idea what that is. I don't think things it. But then Minecraft zombie spawner. So we're gonna take this little guy with us. I must admit, I love the portal gun, potato portal gun. The new update that has come with the latest patch of portal gun. Made it so he speaks a lot more, and even that slow clap he did, where I did something stupid or something like that, he was, it was sarcastic and being like, oh my God, so good, and not being total sarcastic. Oh, great, my slow clap got back in. Fucking hell. Oh yeah, I forgot I had put, yeah. See, that's the reason. Okay, I want to see if this works. Nope, it didn't. The portal has to be physically inside the portal. That's why I'm gonna do this. Yep, see? Now it works. But to jump through the portal there, did it actually destroy its capability to spawn them? Let us check that out, shall we? Let there be light. Or let there be dark, actually. And Enderman has... What? Why is there so much light here? Huh? I was just about, who's sitting on my horse? Why is there so much light right here? Oh, there we go. Nope, they're spawning. Cool, I can make grinders out of them now. Ow. Look at that. Cool, it actually works. They still work. So, that's a bonus. Okay. Onward to the next one. Let's get the next, next portal in. Yeah, this is a problem. I don't know why, but when I do that with the portal and going through with a spawner, it makes a, it makes that. I don't know why. And the funny thing is that when I go through that, it actually brings me to the normal Nether. Not like a different Nether in another dimension, as we are here, we are in another dimension. But it brings me to the normal Nether, and when I go through it again, it brings me to the normal portal that I have in my basement. It's a bit weird. But now that I know that I can turn it off just by grabbing a block with this one, I don't have to continuously chop down every single block. Okay, next one is the spider spawner. I hope it goes as well as the other one. Oh shit. Oh. I actually just wanted to do that. Okay. Sometimes it's good to have a beard. When it itches on the hand, you can just rub it against the beard and then, yeah, like a good old-fashioned scratch. Nice. Worked like a charm. But this one I am a little bit wary of, so we're gonna place it. I'll place it down here where there's lots of lights, so that it, the cave spiders don't spawn, because they can climb all over the goddamn place. Okay, seems like it worked. Now for the last of the spawners, the normal zombie spawner. Man, the cool things we can make with them. The grinders and stuff like that. Okay, but I do mean, I gotta figure out a hard way to make a good grinder out of with the small guys, because it's just one block tall. Remember the one I got in the backyard where the skeletons go up the water and down and then falls, so they have half a heart left? Oh, let me just check the... Okay, it seems to be good. There's still a little bit of room for improvement. You know what? Let's just take all of the ores right here. Yeah, that's good. As you can see, it's still... Damn. Yeah. Let's be quick about this. I'm thinking of the zombie spawner here. I'm thinking of integrating that into my skeleton grinding machine, so it spawns both skeletons and zombies that goes up the water spout and then falls down. Could be pretty cool. I fly like an eagle, soaring through the sky above. Let's fly like an eagle. Oh my god. Okay. There goes. Whew! Yeah, it does that sometimes. Where it's, the thing I'm holding doesn't reanimate. Okay. Put this baby down here right beside that one. And it's this one I'm talking about, where the skeleton goes up the chute and then falls down. TD equals trapdoor. If switch is up, trapdoor is closed. Switch is down, trapdoor is open. As you can hear, there's already someone in there. The skeleton... plenty of you know already what this machine does. The skeleton spawn, it flows with the water current inside, and then there are staircases and water, which is like a water block here, then a staircase, water block, like that all the way up, so it will have the skeleton automatically climb upwards, because that's the programming of skeletons. They will always go up when there's water. So the skeleton goes up, and then he's two blocks tall, right? So there's water here, he goes up, oh, He hits the water. It goes up. Oh, yes. But then he washed his feet out of the water, but then his head hit the water, and then, yeah. Like that. All the way up. And bam! Just and then there's current flowing down there, and it stops right at the edge, and then... And as you can see, the skeleton have a heart left. Then you can just... like that. So, I'm actually going to implement the zombie spawner into this machine as well, but I'm not gonna do that now. I'm gonna do that off camera. You guys have seen too much of that anyway. Oh yeah, I want to show this. I found it in one of the chests underneath one of the gridwood trees, and it looked pretty goddamn cool, but. Damn, I had never thought it would grow into such a gigantic tree. I mean, this is Nortrisil, goddamn. This is the world tree. This is Nortrisil, the world tree. For fuck's sake. Oh my god, it's so big and majestic that I'm not gonna touch it. It's gonna stay there as it is, pristine. Oh my god, but look, damn, that could have been a cool place to make a treehouse home or something like that. Think of it, having one of those saplings, a Nortrisil sapling, and then just have it grow into one of these big, gigantic behemoths out in the world somewhere, and you got yourself a treehouse. God damn. Is anyone outside? Yeah, I got headphones on, so sometimes I hear stuff. But yeah, look at this. We got these three antler dudes or reindeer dudes. Wild deer, yeah. I'm gonna call them reindeer. But maybe take the name tag and name one of them Rudolph. That could be cool. Okay. First mission, get spawners to overworld. Done. Okay. Now, what the? For fuck's sake, Charlie! You know you can't. You don't do well with water. Hey, Cindy, how you doing, girl? Where's Cooler? He's up there minding his own goddamn business. Okay. Yeah. World domination with open blocks. I'm just racking my brain here, figuring out. Hey, how you doing, Cooler? I was acting fast. Yeah. Racking my brain here too. What the last ingredient or the last thing there could be. Ender lily seed growth 29%, sweet. 14, 29, 14, 29, 0% growth on this one. As you can see, it takes a hell of a long time to have them grow. But watering with this watering can right here makes the growth take just a little bit faster. It's kind of cool. It's real immersive. Okay. Cool. We got ourselves an auto spawner, and I also got myself a safari net with a Enderman in it. Yeah, almost forgot. Let's see here if we can go and come on. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, this here I wanted to make so I could turn off the quarry. But sadly, there is no off button. Whoop, there's no off button on the quarry, so yeah. Okay, wood. Cool. Ores. Things I can get rid of fairly quickly. Bam, bam. Next on the list, this one, this one, this one, this one, these two. Gonna keep that one on me. Got another one. Oh, a poor little puppy. She's yapping in the background because I had to lock her in. Because she is a tornado. I mean, seriously, that dog can rip up a carpet like it's nobody's business. Okay, this is downstairs. Ars Magica, Ars Magica. Thumbcraft, Thumbcraft, and Thumbcraft. Damn. Okay, these three go up in here. Thumbcraft, ores, sticks, and stones. May break my bones, but it doesn't make. Okay. Where's nope. Yeah, you know what? Look how many sticks we got. We got tons of sticks, so screw that. I was talking on my heartstrings that he is over there yapping like a son of a bitch, so yeah. I'll be right back and yeah. See you in a bit. And so we are back. Yeah. If you hear something in the background, it's because I had to take Maisa, our little dog, into my house. But yeah, I just discovered something. I know what the last piece is. I don't know why, it just came to me. I was watching one of Direwolf 20's Let's Plays, and yeah, well actually, his server Let's Play, and the new one he's done, and he's making with my magic and stuff, but yeah. That's the one, Aurum. So Aurum is a combination of magic and air. And yeah, and the owl is a combination of something, I don't know what, but also air. So, this should be very, very easily done. Let's create a couple. There we go. We're gonna go with air. Senses. What was it that... Oh, sorry about that. Let me just check my Pharmanomicon again here. What was it that senses was made out of air and spiritus? And potentia and vacuous. You know what? Vacuous and potentia. Let's make a couple of those. Okay. So, we an air. Okay, cool. So you just have to connect it like that, not... That is so perfect. Goggles of a reeling, my friends. Let us see how they are made. Goggles of Revealing are made in the Arcane Workbench. Cost 5 air, 5 fire, 5 water, 5 earth, 3 potentia, predito, and 3 oro. Also requires 2 golden ingots, 4 pieces of leather, and 2 thermometers or thermometers. Okay then. So, let's go up and make a couple of more thermometers, because with the Goggles of Revealing, you can only see stuff, but you cannot research like you can with the... Charlie, you sometimes are a stupid chicken. Okay. Any type of shard, a piece of glass, and 2 golden ingots. That is a ridiculously easy. Where's the glass? Where the bloody fuck is the glass? Oh well. 1, 2, 1, 2. I think we got something. Nope, we got paints over here, but we don't have any glass. Where the bloody... Oh, that's right. I used it for that. Okay. Yeah. So how are we gonna get ourselves some glass? Moss, cobblestone. You know what, I think we have an idea. Gonna take this. Let it grind up that one. Bam. Switch it up with this one. Okay, cool. Let it burn through that. And do you know what? You don't have to sit and wait. Gonna fast forward this with a bit of magical editing. See you in a bit. And so we are back with a little bit of magical editing. We got all the stuff that we need in order to make ourselves 2 more. 1, 2, 1, 2. Right. Bam. 2 more of these. Okay. Yeah, I think... Oh yeah, I had to go out and slaughter a couple of the cows, but not before re-establishing the hierarchy. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh yeah, it was also the wrong place. I can't make it in there, I have to make it in here. So now I just need to figure out where the heck I put my wand. But can I just leave these in here like so? Yep, I can. Cool. There we go. Now I just need to figure out where the heck I put my wand. Yeah. My game seems to be a bit laggy at the moment. It's like it's hesitating when I open up my inventory. Thank you. As you can see, now it's not buggy anymore. Now I could just pick up the thing, but yeah. Okay, did I put my wand in here? Nope. I'm gonna have to go upstairs and check all the chests. One by one. Nope, no wand in there. That's a dog's chest, no wand in there. Nope. My builder's wand is in here, but not my thermic wand. Where could I have placed my thermic wand? Holy crap. Let's take the things that we can... I gotta stop this quarry somehow when I don't need it. Where did I place my thermal wand? Oh yeah, that's right. For goodness sake. Oh yeah. Got up there now. Rocky Princess, nice. Man. That is so freaking weird. Thumbcraft, grown up, Thumbcraft, Ars Magica. And Ars Magica 2. Nope. And it's not in here. Well, I guess I'm gonna have to make a new wand. That was Ars Magica. Don't you just hate it when that happens? Well, I'm gonna have a look around and see if I can find it. And so, I am back. After a long search, realizing that I couldn't find my wand. Had to make a new one. And, of course, go out and refill it. As you can see up here in the top corner there. I had to refill it with all the different aspects and stuff like that. In order to facilitate our needs. Thank you. So. 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.3, 5.3. That's because I do not have this discount 5%. Oh, damn. Yeah. These cost 110% these cost for this seriously stupid little one. But let's make them. And the last thing we're gonna have to do today. Goggles are revealing. Bam. Why did I... No. Look. I don't know. Okay. That's 105%. It's probably Cindy that hasn't. Yep, that's Cindy. She hasn't eaten yet. Where are you, girl? That's where the heck is she? You stupid dog. There we go. Oh well. Yeah, so. Out on my long search. I actually managed to find some things. This essence or berry bush right here, for example. Thinking a good place for it would be in here somewhere. Not right there. Taking down that light. The essence or berry bush is quite cool. As you can see, I got 32 levels, and I only need that one little bit right there to 33. Look at this. Bam, it actually gives that much. Oh my god. Okay. Oh, yeah, chicken. Charlie. Okay. And I also found, this is my raspberry bushes. I found some other bushes that I've went out and planted. But yeah, so without further ado, we've got our goggles revealing. And yeah, that's gonna be it for today. So thank you all so very much for watching, and catch you on the flip side.